When the child finished his performance, applause as loud as summer rain filled the room. Marie was much too excited to go home, so she hurried down the steps, lay down on the cool grass, and closed her eyes. She thought about the boy and hummed a melody from his concert. "Tomorrow I will try to play this on my piano," she thought eagerly. When she opened her eyes, the boy was standing on the lawn staring down at her.
"So, you liked my music?" he said with a smile.
Marie jumped to her feet. "Oh, did you compose that? Why, you are just a little boy."
"I'm already 7, and you must be about the same age."
"Well, I am, and I also play the piano, but not as well as you. What is your name?"
"Mozart. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, but everyone calls me Wolfel. And you?"
"Marie. I live in the yellow house across the lawn. My father is an officer in Prince Maximilian's army."
"Maximilian invited me to play here tonight. At the moment, there's a banquet being held in my honor. But it was so boring, I simply had to leave. Nobody even noticed."
"I've never seen palace gardens like these before. You must show them to me. Can we borrow one of the gondolas?"
Marie and Wolfeld untied the boat and paddled down the canal. The light of the moon danced on the water and lit up the park. A dog darted out of the woods and lunged toward the boat, splashing loudly as he landed in the water behind them.
Marie laughed and pulled him into the gondola. "This is Ludwig. He still acts like a puppy, although he's already a year old."
Mozart began singing a song about the swimming dog of Nymphenburg, and Ludwig shook furiously, spraying them with water. "One day, Ludwig, you shall appear in one of my operas." They both laughed until their stomachs ached.